first, let me introduce Kevin Lesko, DUSEL Principal Investigator and a Scientist at UC Berkeley. Kevin?
Good morning, Governor Adams. How are you today? They're also like that auto to quad and to bill and to duck. So I'm down here at the 40 and 50 level, and you'll hear a little bit of wind across my mic, but I move forward, they'll get a little wider, so better conversation. But I'd like to again say how important it is what South Dakota has done for us to provide access to us here at the 40 and 50, so that we can actually get down to the locations and do our planning for the science that will come forward with DUSEL. They actually have access here, reduce the risks, makes it a safer endeavor and much more cost effective. So again, we owe a great debt to South Dakota for all they've done to get me, a physicist down here, while my colleague, a geologist, is there in Washington, D.C. So why don't I give you a little orientation of what we're doing down here. Greg and I were down this morning looking at some of the infrastructure improvements, some of the safety enhancements, so we can take this opportunity to show you what we have at 4850 and what our plans are. So behind me over my right shoulder is the Ross. That's one of the ways, the Ross shaft. It's one of the ways to get from the surface down here to the 4850 level. That's how we came down this morning. And I'll walk forward here and show you some more of the 4850 and our plans for this location. So again, the Ross shaft is back that way to get down to the deep levels. In front of me here is the fixed winds that go from 4850 down to the 8,000 foot level. In front of me here are two shafts, or two drifts that make up a triangle. And you saw that in the video. Inside of that triangle of rock, we're envisioning building several laboratory modules, a total length of about 150 meters of lab module and about 20 meters tall. So that you can think about it in terms of a football field in length and a 5 or 6 story building tall. Here underground to house some of these experiments that are really discovery-oriented experiments, experiments that are looking for the next big discoveries in physics. Further down this particular drift here is the Davis Cavity. That's where the astrophysics we heard about in the video got started. That's where in the 60s the first big experiments discovering the problem with neutrinos or emphasizing our lack of knowledge about neutrinos took place back in the Davis Cavity. And then off here to the left-hand side of this drift, to my left, is where these mega cavities would be involved. And these are these large cavities, 65, 60 meters across and tall, big enough for Rushmore, will be carved out of this rock in order to receive a beam of neutrinos coming from Chicago, off in that direction there, coming in across here. Now, this is a little different laboratory than many laboratories. We're not just sitting at one level. Above me, about 2,000 feet, there'll be a series of other experiments installed, one extending from 1700 to the surface to work on carbon sequestration. And then about 2,500 feet below me here, there'll be another lab module, and that will be something on the order of 15 to 20 meters across and maybe 70 meters long, large enough to house some additional physics experiments that are being looking for the most difficult particles to detect, some of the rarest decays that need the best shielding that would be located down below us here. So this is a three-dimensional laboratory that's going to be built here. And again, having the access here allows us to do the design work at a much advanced level than we would just be able to